Welcome everyone to this review of a Samsung M20 and completely cheap 229 or something euro dollar entry level phone that is usually only on sale in other markets like India, Africa, Asia, Europe and Latin America and such. In Germany this was only supposed to be on sale on 3 days or something like this, but somehow Amazon apparently still has stock. And I wondered, can this kind of cheap phone be good? I actually wondered if I can give it to my wife because she's too often dropping iPhones and I'm tired of repairing them. And I thought this large display as well as large battery would be good for her. But I had to find out there are some drawbacks of this cheap phone that are maybe not the most amazing for people who take photos and such. So comparing this to a Samsung Galaxy S10e is of course comparing flagship to entry level, and I have to say for the most part you can actually really use it, although for me personally it would be too large, but of course I know many people love big phones. For me this S10e size is nearly perfect, but more to this in another video. Aside from this, in my opinion this is totally amazing bang for the buck, 229 or so euro or dollar. Of course gives you super large screen, super large battery, yet a fingerprint reader and a headphone jack and USB-C for all of those who would want this, as well as a dual SIM card and micro SD slot. And it is totally usable. Of course the specifications are not that precise. They're listed here as an Exynos octa-core 40 nanometer 7904, while from the S10e it is not that precisely listed here. I think I have this Exynos here as well in the S10e, but you see from the GPU they list here for the S10e a Mali G76 MP12, while for this M20 they only list a Mali G71 MP2. So of course slightly less graphic performance there, no surprise there for entry-level territory. However, it is totally usable, so you can do everything, browse internet, obviously make videos and all this kind of fun. The real drawbacks are, however, the camera and the sound, in my opinion. Maybe for most people the sound still would be okay, because what my iPhone also didn't have is stereo speakers, and I really like those on the S10e, for example, that I have a slightly wider sound here when I play my own YouTube videos. The M20, however, leaves you just with mono speakers, leaving you with the same degraded speaker quality that I lived myself for many years. Of course, you can live with it, not such a big of a deal. The really primary issue why many people might not totally love this as a daily driver is the camera. And while, of course, it makes okay photos here, even a dual lens there, more than you got on even iPhones until a couple of years, the photos are not as amazing as, for example, flagship S10 territory. But obviously there needs to be some compromise here for the 229 non-flagship territory. The biggest thing, in my opinion, of course, it's slightly less sharp in everything. But if you zoom in a little bit, you will see that the M20 makes way rounder photos. That is really annoying, as you can see. So the lens, the optics are way better here on the S10e, but that certainly should not surprise many. This is as visible on selfies as well as architecture. While of course you can take photos like this, it's simply not as amazing, not as a premium of a lens. And this is also similar visible on architecture, nature, selfies and such. My wife totally didn't like the selfie quality there. It's similar distorted, especially if you use this non-tele modus there. So yeah, I will also show you some more detailed examples, but to conclude this review and experiment here, you get a surprisingly a lot of phone for 229 euro, totally usable for everyday stuff. And I understand that certain markets the salary is just not as high, and this is why I even for myself don't like the high prices of Apple's devices, especially in Europe where they overcharge over 15% more. And this kind of phone really shows you how much value you get for this kind of money. And again, if you can live with mono speakers and are not as much in photo and videography, then completely amazing deal here. And I hope you enjoyed this quick overview. Certainly don't really need to browse the internet here. It is as snappy on YouTube and the internet as another phone, certainly nowadays with octa-core and whatnot. As you may be able to see, just way more detail here, the famous unbox therapy like beard test here, way more details, way sharper. Also, as I said, for architecture, especially with this less corrected lens setup there, you should be able to see the curving here of this lens setup, also even on this SparkStation IPX PCB here. Even here you see more crisp colors, more details, but no surprise for 30% of the price. I hope you liked this quick review here of the Samsung Galaxy M20, and as I said, completely usable everyday phone if you don't have too high quality expectations for photography as well as stereo sound. Otherwise, good for sports, I guess, bicycle, running, sailing, whatnot, it can drop. And if you use it at work for outdoor activities and such, it's not too huge of an investment if it eventually breaks or something like that. UI-wise, of course, this is quite similar. Didn't see too much of a difference here settings-wise and such. Although I wish all the vendors would simply install stock vanilla Android, but that is probably a topic for another video. I always find it slightly funny when they put this fancy brand advertisement stuff, Vaporware features somewhere like Dolby Atoms here, and then when you try to select it, it shows the sound effects work in earphone and Bluetooth headset modes only. So yeah, so much to that mono speakers. I hope you enjoyed this quick test here, and I hope to see you soon for the next videos to come.